the first thing that hit me as I was watching, as they talked about the series with the Pacers, and Jordan talked about in 1998, and Jordan talked about how tough it was. And it was probably his toughest, he said it was his toughest series outside of when they used to play Detroit before he won championships. And what hit me at that moment was, man, the game was during the Jordan era, almost exclusively the Jordan era, the game was so physical. I mean, he had to go through this era that very few players, like before that in the 80s with Bird and Magic. Now, there were obviously some physical plays with the Kevin McHale and the clothesline of Kurt Rambis. And, you know, there was Dr. J and Larry Bird getting into a fight. But the game still was more offense. It was very high scoring in the 80s. Very much up and down. Not the type of physical defense overall. Obviously in some individual instances, as I just said. But overall, the 90s was the most physical era of basketball we've ever seen. And that was the Jordan era. And that's what he had to go through. I've already said he had to go through the greatest era of big men that we've ever seen. There was Shaq, a young Shaq, but Shaq was in the league for, you know, Jordan's first 5-6 years, you know. There was Hakeem Olajuwon, David Robinson, Alonzo Mourning. You know, I mean, there were big men, Patrick Ewing. It was the greatest era of centers we ever saw. And then it was the most physical era, period, especially with power forwards. So Jordan, who was a notorious driver to the basket, you could see that whenever he went to the hole, it was just, I mean, people were ready to hammer him. And I looked at it and I said, you know what? He had Detroit to go through, who kind of ushered in that era of physical play in the late 80s. And then he had the Knicks to go through, who, I mean, my goodness, Anthony Mason, Xavier McDaniel, Charles Oakley, Patrick Ewing. It was incredible. Charles Smith, the physicality in those series that Jordan had to go through. And then top it off with the Indiana Pacers. And you look at the scores of some of these games, some of these finals games that Jordan played, 73, they're in the 70s. I remember that's when I first started covering the league. I covered the Cleveland Cavaliers under Mike Fratello, who were one of the most, the slowest teams in the league, if not the slowest. And I regularly saw games in the 60s and 70s. Jordan's averaging 30 in games that end in the 70s and the 80s, you know, and that last series, 98, he averaged 45 in those, or I'm sorry, he scored 45 in game six, and the Bulls as a team scored 87. He scored more than half, well over half the points, or over half the points. So that is that physical play. And look, I don't wish that we go back to that. I mean, it was what it was. Jordan was beautiful to watch. I prefer the game more free-flowing and wide open as it is today. Maybe you could find a balance, you know, but that was an extreme. And but that's what Jordan had to go through. And the league was always looking for ways to up the scoring, get the game to be more free-flowing, less physical. That's why they put in the zone defense, the kind of truncated zone. You can't play a full zone, but you know, you got a zone defense that you could play. That's why they got rid of hand checking. That's why for three seasons, the three-point line was shorter. They were looking for ways to increase scoring because it was so low. And in the midst of all that, physicality, low scoring, Jordan still averages 30. And it was incredible. But that was the first takeaway when I was looking back at that Indiana series. Man, it was so tough and brutal in his era. almost, you know, when he's done, you start kind of coming out of that physical play. But that's what he had to go through.
For the best access, perspective, and personalities in all of sports, follow us at Fox Sports on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube.